Greetings everyone, welcome to lesson 5. Today we are going to talk about the following topics. What is right issue? What is buyback? How does index works, or what is index? And what is the balance sheet of the company? So without wasting much time, let's get started. First, let's talk about rights issue. Now, rights issue is a special type of issue of shares done by a company just like IPO, but it is only for the existing shareholders. That means company wants to sell more of its shares, but only to its existing shareholders at a discounted price. When company have shortage of capital, they dilute more shares, and to attract the existing investors, they offer more shares at a discounted price. So that means when a company wants to grow further and it is facing a lack of money, it wants to get more money by diluting its shares. Now, the best way to get more money by diluting its share is to provide a discount to its existing shareholders and ask them or offer them the shares at a discounted price. That issue is called as rights issue. It is just like IPO, where company is trying to raise capital by diluting the shares, but here it is diluting its share by it's diluting its shares to only its existing shareholders. Now, rights issue is in proportion to how many shares the investor hold. For example, if you are holding only one share, in the rights issue you cannot buy 100 shares or 1000 shares. There will be always a proportion of rights issue of how, depending upon how many number of shares you are already holding. For example, if the rights issue is in the ratio of 1:1, that means for every 10 shares you have, you can buy only 10 new shares, or for every 50 shares you have, you can buy 50 new shares only. You cannot buy more than that. So rights issue is given or distributed in proportion to how many shares the investor holds. And in most of the cases, rights are transferable. That means if you do not want to buy the shares, but if anyone else from your circle wants to buy the shares, you can transfer your rights to someone else and they can use your rights to buy the shares. Now, if a company is selling shares to existing shareholders at a lower price, it looks a very attractive deal as a shareholder, and we will tend to buy them at a lower price. However, the rights issue are a risky bet because a company is issuing share because it needs money to grow and survive, which is not a good sign. It shows company is not able to sustain itself and needs funds to sustain, and hence diluting its shares. So be very careful before investing into rights issue. The next term that we are going to discuss is buyback. Buyback, as the name suggests, is company buying back its shares. Now, this is exactly opposite to rights issue. Here, the company buys back the share from the existing shareholders. Companies, in fact, offer extra price above the current market price to attract the investors. Now, for a company to take back its share from the existing shareholder, it obviously have to offer them a better deal than the current market price. Only then the people will sell their shares to the company back. Now, why do company do buyback? Company does buyback when company wants to accumulate its own shares, and it does this to increase its own internal stakes. Sometimes buyback is also done when a company has excess of money, and instead of investing it somewhere else, company decides to invest in itself. And sometimes company wants to give shares to their employees but don't want to dilute its own holding. So they buy it from the public and then distribute it to the employees. Now, buyback is a really positive news about the company, because if a company is buying back its own share, that means company believes in itself and company is all set to grow. And that is why share prices usually go up when a buyback is announced. So when a company gives shares to the public, it is called as rights issue or IPO. And when it takes the shares from the public, it is called as buyback. The next term that we are going to talk about is index. Index is a basket of stock which helps you measure the change in the market and represents overall health of the market or specific sector. You might have heard about most famous indices like Nifty, Bank Nifty, Sensex, etc. Now, if you talk about Nifty, it's an index of NSE and is made up of top 50 companies of India. Similarly, BSE has its own index called as Sensex, and it is made up of top 30 companies of India. If Nifty or Sensex is positive, that means top companies of India are doing well and creates a positive sentiment in the market, which results in market going up. Just like Nifty and Sensex, we have sector specific index like Bank Nifty, Nifty IT, Nifty Pharma, etc. Now Bank Nifty is made up of only banking stocks and it represents the overall health of the banks. If the banks are performing well, Bank Nifty will go up. If the banks are not performing well, Bank Nifty will go down. Similarly, Nifty Pharma is made up of pharma stocks, CNX IT is made up of IT stocks, Nifty Auto is made up of automobile stocks. You cannot directly invest in index, that is, you cannot buy one share of Nifty or two shares of Nifty or 10 shares of Sensex. You cannot directly invest into index. However, you can trade them via futures and options, that is F&O. We are going to discuss in detail about futures and options in our coming series. However, currently you can understand that index will basically help you understand the overall health of the market. We are also going to discuss about index in detail in our upcoming upcoming videos. Now this is a small example of Sensex. Now you can see that Sensex is made up of top 30 companies of India, and I have a graph of Sensex running from 2006 to 2020. Now you can see that when the market was going up, Sensex was going up. You might have heard about market crashing down in 2008. So the first red box represents the market crash in 2008, where Sensex came down. That means top 30 companies of India came down, and naturally the entire Indian market came down. From 2009 onwards, our economy started flourishing and our economy started booming up. From 2009, the Sensex went up from 8,000 all the way to around 40,000 rupees. So Indian market really went up, or basically I can say that from 2019 to 2020, Indian economy grew by fivefolds, because the Sensex went from 8,000 to 40,000. However, recently due to coronavirus outbreak, from 40,000, Sensex again fell down to 29,000. As of now, today, it is 29,000. So Sensex represents the overall health of the market, or Nifty also represents the overall health of the market. We see that during recessions or during bad economic phases, Sensex or Nifty tends to fall down, telling you that markets are not well. However, when the economy is flourishing, Sensex or Nifty goes up, telling you that it's a good time to invest and market is going up. We are going to talk about this also in detail in our upcoming classes. Apart from this, the next topic that we're going to talk about is a balance sheet. What is a balance sheet? Basically, it's a financial statement of a company which includes assets, liabilities, etc. Basically, it will tell you how much assets a company has or how much liability a company has, and it will help you evaluate the company. Balance sheet is also one of the ideal tool to measure the growth of a company. Now you can measure the growth of a company using balance sheet and also compare it versus its peers. We'll show you a live example by going into the screener.in. Now say I go to screener.in website. Here, if I want to check the performance of the company, or if I want to understand the fundamentals of a company, I will check the balance sheet of a company. For example, say I want to check TCS. So I'll just write TCS, and there you go. TCS market capitalization is of 6,74,575 crore. It's a very big company. The current market price, the per share price, is 1,797. We also have other details like 52 week high, 52 week low. That means in the last 1 year, the highest price per share was 2,296 and the lowest price was 1,504. Apart from that, there are a lot of other interesting data about this company. However, at the top, you can see that there is a balance sheet. If I click on balance sheet, it will show me the balance sheet for last 11-12 years. So from March 2008, I have balance sheet till September 2019. And you can see that in the balance sheet, it is showing me total liabilities, total assets, how much is the borrowing that the company has done, how much reserves a company has, how much liabilities it has, what are the fixed assets, what are the investment, what are the other assets. Apart from balance sheet, the other important fundamental sheets are profit and loss statement. In the profit and loss, you can make out that how much profit a company is making or how much loss a company is making. For example, in March 2019, we made a profit of 39,506 crore. In March 2018, we made a profit of 32,516 crore. These are our operating profits, and you have here profit before tax. In March 2017, it was 34,513. In March 2018, it was 34,092. So there are a lot of other factors which will help you understand whether which will help you evaluate and understand whether a company is making more profits compared to its previous years or less profits compared to its previous years. Similarly, we have, apart from profit and loss statement, you have cash flow statement also, which will tell you whether a company is earning the cash or losing the cash. Like for example, in March 2017, company was actually losing, it was losing 2698 crore rupees, and in March 2018 it recovered and it became plus 1286. So minus means that the cash is going from the company, and plus means the cash is coming inside the company. So you can also understand whether a company is doing good or not by the cash flow statement. These are all a part of fundamental analysis. We are going to talk about this also in detail in a separate series of fundamental analysis. So basically, balance sheet helps an investor evaluate the growth of a company and compare it with its peers. Balance sheet also helps you evaluate major ratios like PE, EPS, ROC. Again, we are going to talk about these also in detail in the fundamental series. Apart from balance sheet, as said, the other useful statements are cash flow statement, income statement. The website to get all financial statement, this is one of the best website, www.screener.in. Apart from that, there are a lot of other websites also, you can explore them. So this was a brief introduction to equity markets. Thank you so much, and spread the knowledge because it's free. So here we finish the basic classes. In the next video, I am going to show you how to place orders in the live markets using a trading terminal. So if you have not opened a Demat account yet, you can open one by signing up by clicking on the link in the descriptions. If you already have a Demat account, I will show you how to place buy orders, sell orders, bracket orders, cover orders, how to keep a target, how to keep a stop loss, all of this in detail in the next class. So thank you so much. Do like, subscribe and share, and I'll see you in the next video.